When it comes to troubleshooting some of the most common computer hardware issues, it's usually down to two components, and that's the RAM, also called memory, and the hard drive or SSD. Now, obviously, a computer has a lot more components than just RAM and a hard drive or SSD, but usually when you're troubleshooting hardware issues on your computer, you definitely want to have a look at both of those components as well. And in this video, I'm going to take you through a step-by-step guide showing you software that you can use to determine if your hard drive or SSD is faulty. Now, with that being said, in this video, I'm going to be using two different free programs. One is Seagate SeaTools and the other one is Crystal Disk Info. And I'll have the links to both of these web pages in my written guide on my website, and you can find a link to that in the description of this video. Now, before downloading these programs, I just want to mention that normally the manufacturer of your hard drive or SSD will have its own software that you can also use to monitor the health and test that drive. But in this video, I just want to show you these two programs that you can use to test the health of your hard drive or SSD, regardless of the brand of that drive. So if we start off with SeaTools and we go to the downloads tab here, we're going to have a few download options. One of them is going to be for Windows, and you also have a Linux version. Now, in this video, I'm going to be using the Windows version, so I'm just going to click on download to download it. Once you have this installer, you can just click on it to open it and then just go through the normal setup prompts. There's not really much to say about this. It's just like installing any other program, and you can just go ahead and click on next until it's finished, and then you can leave this checkbox selected to launch the application and then just click on finish. So we're going to be using Seagate first, but I'll show you Crystal Disk Info later on in this video as well. So right now Seagate SeaTools is launching. I'm just going to leave that on English, then click on next. Then you'll have to accept this license, so just click on the checkbox there and then click on submit, and then you're going to be taken into the main interface here. Now you can see it gives you a lot of info with regards to these drives. So if we have a look at this SSD here, it shows me how much free space I have. It shows me the life percentage that's left on that drive. This is the total amount of terabytes that can be written to these SSDs. Then it also shows me the status of these drives here. And then I have some options here to run a quick test. And I can also click on drive details, which will show me more info with regards to that drive here. Now, I'm not going to be going through every single one in this video. What I want to show you is how you can test your drives to determine if there's something wrong with your SSD or hard drive. Now, as you can see here, the status of all of these drives are green with a green check mark, meaning they're all fine with the initial tests that Seagate SeaTools performed, but you also have the option of performing extended tests up here. So for the sake of this video, I'm just going to run a quick test on this SSD here just to show you what it looks like. And if I click on that, it's just going to run a short generic test on that drive to determine if there's any issues. Now, normally, if you're testing a drive, you don't just want to test it with a short test, because it doesn't scan the entire drive like an extended test would. But as you can see, the short generic test passed, and it's just a quick way of checking if the drive is faulty. And if you had any errors up until this point, then you know you need to replace the drive. But the correct way to test these drives is to go ahead and select the drive. Then you can go to the extended tests button up here, and then you can do a long generic test. So if I go ahead and click on that, it's going to open a new window where I can go ahead and do this long test. And this is going to take much longer than the short test, but it's a better way of determining if the drive is faulty or not. Now, for this video, I'm just going to click on cancel because I'm not going to be going through that. But what I want to show you next is when it comes to this hard drive here, disk one, and these two SSDs, they are all internal drives. And as you can see, this one says IDE, but it's actually SATA. It's connected with a SATA cable. This one is an NVMe drive, so it's connected directly on my motherboard. This hard drive here is also IDE or SATA, but this drive down here, this hard drive, is connected with USB. So you can also use this program to test your external hard drives, and that's what I want to show you here, because this drive here, disk 3, that's connected to USB. Right here, it says the status is fine with this green check mark here. But if I go ahead and I run a quick test on this, and we have a look at the short self-test that's running, right there, you saw that it just aborted the middle of the test. So it says that the results right here, it started the short self-test, and then 10 seconds later, it just aborted the test. So I'm going to run the quick test again, and I'll show you. It's going to try running it again. It's not going to get past 10%. It's just going to abort the test exactly like it did there. And if I click on the results, you'll see it basically aborted itself after 10 seconds again. So that means something is wrong with this drive because it couldn't complete the test. And I wanted to show you this so I can mention that even though it says the status is fine and it's not displaying any life expectancy, if you try and do a test and the test cancels itself, it also means there's something wrong with that drive. Now, yes, I am connecting this drive with a USB cable, and you could argue that the next logical step that you would want to take is to get this drive physically connected into the computer, also with a SATA connection, and then run the test directly from a SATA cable and not with a USB conversion. Now, I'm not going to be doing that in this video, but I'm just mentioning it to you that in case you do have an external hard drive that's connected with USB and the same thing happens to you, just to double check that the drive is faulty, instead of connecting it via USB, you can connect it directly to your motherboard with the SATA connection and then try and run the test again. And also another thing we can try here is to select this drive and then do a long generic test and go ahead and start that test. But if it doesn't even complete the quick test, it's definitely not gonna complete the long test as well. So I'm just gonna cancel it for this video. And the point I'm trying to make to you is don't just launch the Seagate SeaTools software and then look at the status here and think everything is fine because there's a green check mark. You have to go and select these drives and do tests on them. You can do the quick tests, but the better thing to do would be to run the long generic tests. Now that takes me to my next point, and that is the fact that if you do get some errors on these drives, sometimes the software might prompt you to fix the errors. So as you can see, there's a fix all button here, and if I click on that, I can fix any errors that got detected during the short test. Now, if you have the option to fix some of the errors, you can go ahead and do that, but that is not a long-term solution to the problem that you have with that drive. If the software detected any errors at all, you need to get another drive and try and copy the data that you have on this faulty drive onto the new drive, because the faulty drive has to be replaced. You can't just fix the errors and then expect the drive to work properly going forward. That's like putting band-aids on an open wound. That's just not gonna work. You need to get that drive replaced and dispose of the faulty drive. And with that being said, that counts for any drive that's connected to your computer. Don't just think because it's another drive that's not your C drive, your main drive where Windows is installed, you can just leave it plugged into the computer and use the computer as normal, because Windows is going to start giving you all sorts of errors and you're going to start having boot issues, because Windows is going to try and run check disk on that drive every time it boots up, and you're going to wonder why your computer isn't working properly. If you have any drive, a hard drive or SSD attached to your computer, and you've gotten any errors on it, or you weren't able to test it using the software, then you need to replace that drive. There's just no other way about it. But if we have a look at the software here, you also have an advanced tab where you can see some more info with regards to these drives. So if you select one of these, you also have some other options here that you might find useful. Like I said, I'm not going to be going through everything in this video, but you can also use it to format your drives or securely erase any data. And then you can go to the utility tab here to create a bootable USB drive that runs this version of Seagate SeaTools in a Linux environment, so you can test your drives in that. And you might want to use that on a computer that you can't get to boot up in Windows. Then you also have a link to the Seagate Disk Wizard software that helps you create and format partitions, that allows you to clone data to a new drive and also allows you to back up your data. But the main thing I wanted to show you in Seagate SeaTools is how to use it to test your drives. So if we go ahead and we look at Crystal Disk Info, just in case you don't want to use Seagate SeaTools or you have some issue with it, you can click on the Crystal Disk Info download link here. It's going to take you to a new page where the download should start automatically. Then you can just run the executable file to start the installation, accept the terms, and then just click on next until it gets installed. That's basically the same for any other program. And then I'm just not going to visit the website now, but I'll launch Crystal Disk Info and then click on finish. And this is what the Crystal Disk Info software looks like. As you can see up here, I've got the same drives that I had in Seagate SeaTools. I'm quickly going to go through them as well, but you can basically see the temperatures up here, which is good. So basically, we can have a look at these drives here. This is the NVMe that I've got installed. The health status is still good, and I can also see the temperature here. Now, if we go through these drives here, this is the terabyte hard drive that I have which is connected with a SATA cable or serial ATA. And I also know it's a hard drive by looking at the rotation rate here, because if I select the other drive, which is the SATA or serial ATA solid state drive, which it also says there, this shows me the total host reads and total host writes and the total NAND writes. So for hard drives, you'll have the rotation rate, and for SSDs, you'll have the total amount of writes displayed here. So obviously these three drives look good, but if we have a look at this drive, which is the one that's connected via USB, as you can see, it's USB, but it also says serial ATA because it's a serial ATA to USB converter that I'm using to connect this drive to the computer. Now, as you can see, it says caution when looking at the health status for this drive, where all of the other drives are good. And like I showed you in Seagate SeaTools, this is the drive that I was unable to test. And because I was unable to test it, it basically means that there is something wrong with that drive. Now you can see some more information here, and we can actually see what the issues are. So it says reallocated sectors count, and then current pending sector count and uncorrectable sector count. Like I explained earlier, if you have any errors on these drives, don't try and repair it. You need to see if you can copy the data to a new drive, but you need to replace your drive and don't take any chances using a faulty drive in your computer. So Crystal Disk Info is really good to get an overall look at the drives in your computer and to determine what their health status is. But usually when testing drives, I like to use Seagate SeaTools, as it just provides me with all of the necessary info and functions inside of one program. Now, if you can't currently get your computer to boot into Windows and you want to test the hard drive or SSD to determine if it's faulty, you will need to use another computer or borrow a friend's computer to create a bootable USB flash drive. And in that case, you can use this SeaTools utility here to create a bootable version of the Seagate SeaTools utility, which you can then use to boot from in your faulty computer and then test the drive in that computer. Another thing you can do is to use the Hirons Boot CD Windows PE environment, which also has a lot of useful utilities that can help you determine if your hard drive or SSD is faulty. And I've previously made a video on this channel showing you how you can use Ventway to create a rescue disk, and that video will show you a step-by-step process that you can follow to create that bootable USB flash drive and boot into Hirons, which you can then use to access a lot of useful utilities to check the health of that hard drive or SSD. Now, this video is part of a playlist showing you how you can test various components in your computer and diagnose any hardware issues you might be having. And I'll also leave a link to the playlist down in the description of this video. But if this video was useful, please give it a like. And if you want to support this channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.